Psychosexual Tube, Major Theories of Sigmund Freud.
According to the famous psychoanalyst Sigmund Freud, children go through a series of psychosexual stages that lead to the development of the adult personality. Freud believed that personality developed through a series of childhood stages in which the pleasure-seeking energies of the id become focused on certain erogenous areas.
Psychosocial Theory, Major Theories of Erik Erikson.
Psychosocial development is just a fancy phrase that refers to how a person's individual needs measure the needs or demands of society. According to Erikson, a person passes through 8 developmental stages that build on each other. At each stage, we face a crisis, and by resolving the crisis, we develop psychological strengths or character traits that help us become confident and healthy people.
Classical conditioning, Major Theories of Ivan Pavlov and John Watson.
Also known as Pavlovian or respondent conditioning, is learning through association and was discovered by Pavlov, a Russian physiologist. In simple terms, two stimuli are linked together to produce a new learned response in a person or animal.
Operant conditioning, Major Theories of B.F. Skinner.
Operant conditioning, also known as instrumental conditioning, is a method of learning normally attributed to B.F. Skinner, where the consequences of a response determine the probability of it being repeated. Through operant conditioning, behavior which is reinforced will likely be repeated, and behavior which is punished will occur less frequently.
Social Cognitive Theory, Major Theories of Albert Bandura.
Proposed by Albert Bandura, emphasizes the importance of observing, modeling, and imitating the behaviors, attitudes, and emotional reactions of others. Social learning theory considers how both environmental and cognitive factors interact to influence human learning and behavior.
Theories of Cognitive Development, Major Theories of Jiang Piaget.
Piaget believed that humans also adapt to their physical and social environments in which they live. The process of adaptation begins since birth. Piaget saw this adaptation in terms of two basic processes, assimilation and accommodation.
Information Processing, Major Theories of Richard Atkinson and Richard Schifrin.
The theory is based on the idea that humans process the information they receive rather than merely responding to stimuli. This perspective equates the mind to a computer, which is responsible for analyzing information from the environment.
Humanistic Theories, Major Theories of Carl Rogers and Abraham Maslow.
It is an approach which studies the whole person and the uniqueness of each individual. The humanistic approach emphasizes the personal worth of the individual, the centrality of human values, and the creative, active nature of human beings. The approach is optimistic and focuses on the noble human capacity to overcome hardship, pain, and despair.
Socio-cultural theory, Major Theories of Lev Vygotsky.
According to Vygotsky, children are born with basic biological constraints on their minds. Each culture, however, provides tools of intellectual adaptation. These tools allow children to use their abilities in a way that is adaptive to the culture in which they live. Learning has its basis in interacting with other people.
Biological System Model, Major Theories of Yuri Bronfenbrenner and Stephen Sesse.
It offers a framework through which community psychologists examine individuals' relationships within communities and the wider society. The theory is also commonly referred to as the ecological or systems framework. It identifies 5 environmental systems with which an individual interacts: the microsystem, mesosystem, exosystem, macrosystem, and the chronosystem.
Evolutionary Psychology Theory, Major Theories of Charles Darwin, David Pusk, Conrad Lorenz, and Robert Sapolsky.
Evolution or change over time occurs through the processes of natural and sexual selection. In response to problems in our environment, we adapt both physically and psychologically to ensure our survival and reproduction.
Attachment Theory, Major Theories of John Bowlby.
This theory mainly focuses on the relationships and bonds between people, particularly long-term relationships. He simply defined attachment as a lasting psychological connectedness between human beings. Attachment theory explains how the parent-child relationship emerges and influences subsequent development. Because the caregiver feeds the child and provides nourishment, the child becomes attached.
Continuous versus discontinuous development. Continuous development sees development as a cumulative process. It means that development occurs gradually over time. In contrast, discontinuous development theories believe that children develop more discreetly in a series of steps or stages. With this type of development, the change is more sudden. Continuous or discontinuous development? Psychosexual theory, discontinuous. There are distinct stages of development. Psychosocial theory, discontinuous. There are distinct stages of development. Classical conditioning, continuous. Learning is ongoing without distinct stages. Apparent conditioning, continuous. Learning is ongoing without distinct stages. Social cognitive theory, continuous. Learning is gradual and ongoing without distinct stages. Piaget's theory of cognitive development, discontinuous. There are distinct stages of development. Information processing, continuous. Cognitive development is gradual and ongoing without distinct stages. Humanistic theories, continuous. Development is ongoing without distinct stages and can be multidirectional depending on environmental circumstances. Social-cultural theory, both but mostly continuous as an individual learns and progresses. Bioecological systems model, both the influence of each system can be continuous or discontinuous depending on the system in question. Evolutionary psychology theory, continuous. Current behaviors have been shaped over multiple generations based on successful survival and reproduction. John Bowlby theory, discontinuous. There are distinct stages of development.
One course versus multi-course development. One course development theories explain that development is essentially the same or universal for everyone, while multi-course development theories stated that behaviors may vary by person. This simply means that everyone follows a different course for each child, depending on the child's genetics and experiences. Psychosexual theory, one course stages are universal for everyone. Psychosocial theory, one course stages are universal for everyone. Classical conditioning, many courses learned behaviors vary by person. Operant conditioning, many courses learned behaviors vary by person. Social cognitive theory, many courses learned behaviors vary by person. Piaget's theory of cognitive development, one course stages are universal for everyone. Information processing, one course the model applies to everyone. Humanistic theories, mostly one course. Maslow's hierarchy of needs is universally applied, but there is an individual course for self-actualization. Sociocultural theory, many courses. There are variations between individuals and cultures. Bioecological system model, many courses. The interaction of people and the environment varies. Evolutionary psychology theory, both. Behavioral genetics show similarities across the species, but our unique family history also plays a role in development. Attachment theory, one course, stages are universal for everyone.
Nature versus nurture involves the extent to which particular aspect of behavior are a product of either inherited genetic or acquired learned influences. Nature refers to the genes and hereditary factors that influence who we are, from our physical appearance to our personality characteristics. On the other hand, nurture refers to the influence of external factors such as childhood experiences, social relationships, and culture. Psychosexual theory. Both natural impulses combined with early childhood experiences impact development. Psychosocial theory. Both natural impulses combined with socio-cultural experiences impact development. Classical conditioning. Mostly nurture, behavior is conditioned. Apparent conditioning. Mostly nurture, behavior is conditioned. Social cognitive theory or social learning theory. Mostly nurture, behavior is observed and learned. Piaget theory of cognitive development. But natural impulses combined with experiences that challenge the existing schemas. Information processing. Both natural cognitive development combined with experience of processing information in new and different ways. Humanistic theories. Mostly nurture, development is influenced by environmental circumstances and social interaction. Socio-cultural theory. Both development is influenced by biological preparation and social experiences. Bioecological system model. Both a person's biological potential and the environment interact to impact development. Evolutionary psychology theory. Both our genetic history and biological impulses interact with life experiences to produce individual development and development across the history and future of the species.
Attachment theory. Both natural impulses combined with relationship experiences impact attachment and development.
This will all make sense when I am older. Someday I will see that this makes sense. One day when all that wise, I think back and realize that these were all completely normal events. I have all the answers when I'm older. Like we're in this dark enchanted world. I know in a couple years this will chill to Charles Spears. So and oh, this is bad. It's good. Excuse me? Growing up, misadapted, bustling a world in your place. When I'm more mature, I feel totally secure, being watched by something with creepy, creepy face. It all makes sense when I am older. So there's no need to be terrified or tense. I'll just dream about a time when I'm in my age of prime. When I'm older, absolutely everything